Okay, did you guys see this TikTok over the weekend? So this is a news article, so the window's kind of funny looking. But basically, this guy got people's attention in relation to HelloFresh. And I want to talk to you guys about this. Okay, hold on. Everyone grab your waters. Okay, hold on. Let me also... Oh, God, sweaty ass legs, bros. Okay. So, when I first saw this story, I lost it. I was ranting. I was raving. I was sending angry messages to my sister on Marco Polo. I was yelling at my partner about, like, the bullshit of this story. I was like, scammer, 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 scammer. But then, my sister and my partner reminded me of a bubble that I often forget exists. So I'm not going to tell you which bubble it is yet, but when you watch this video with me, I want to know, and type as you're feeling it, like type as much as you want, okay? I want you guys to write down in the comments how he makes you feel, the chances the story is accurate, and then how much of it feels true to you, like intuitively, right? Really fast comment from Angelica says, the fact that so many people thought you would never find someone because you're too picky and still found someone gives me a lot of hope. Good. I'm so glad. That's what I want to hear. But also, I hate to say this, but not really. There are 8 billion people on the planet. Do you really think being picky is the reason people don't get married? Like, I just feel like people can... Have you never met the most hype, maintenance, picky bitches of all time somehow find husbands? I don't think it's a matter of finding a partner. I think finding a partner is easy. There are plenty of people who are willing to date anybody. I think finding the right partner who speaks to you and brings you joy is difficult because there's so many people on the planet. And I was lucky enough to perfectly find... And I can't wait to tell you guys, like, how we met and how it all happened because I think it's just crazy. I think it's like a crazy story, but it also makes so much sense. Like, of course it happened that way. It couldn't have happened any other way, but we're not ready to come out with our story yet. So be patient. When we are established and we've talked about it privately as a couple, we will probably do a podcast. Okay. So let's go ahead and watch this TikTok video. This is from the Daily Dot, and this TikToker has 2 videos. I just want to, okay. So we're going to watch part 1 and part 2. Okay. Ready? Again. Just give your opinions and then we'll get into it. Okay, ready? Oh, I'm so excited to watch this with you. Let me know how his volume is. I'm gonna turn it up, so it might be a little bit loud. Okay, let's see. Oh, wait, I don't have my earphones. No, oh, I fucked it up.
Because of HelloFresh, I'm going hungry for the next 5 days. My first box ever, I decided to try HelloFresh because...
He sounds low to me.
Because groceries are getting way too...
Is he okay? I'm going to rewind it and start it from the beginning, too. Does that kind of... Is that okay?
Because of HelloFresh, I'm going hungry for the next 5 days.
Is the volume...
My first box ever. I decided to try HelloFresh because groceries are getting way too expensive, and the economy sucks, and I figured, you know what? What the hell? So I used a discount and I got a HelloFresh box. I was supposed to be delivered yesterday. Me not having very much money decided I'm not gonna buy more groceries. I have enough to last me until Monday. Well, yesterday was Monday and my box was supposed to come. It didn't. I checked the fucking tracking and it tells me, oh, there's a road closed in your area. There's more than one way to get to my house. There isn't just one road. So I talked to customer service, and they told me that it was a weather condition. Well, that struck me as funny because it's a sunny day, completely clear, everywhere within 100 square miles of me. So which is it? Is it weather or is it construction? Because the tracking number says construction, but the HelloFresh customer support says it's weather. Well, they end up chalking it up to their mistake. So they say, oh, rest assured, your box will be delivered tomorrow and we'll issue a full refund for your first box because of the delay. I thought, great, you know, I'll get my box tomorrow. I'll have to suffer today and be hungry for a day. But, you know, I can do it because I'm looking forward to the meals that I got.
Does anyone Okay, just we're a minute and 24 seconds in. What are we feeling? So far, he says, okay, my delivery is late. I'll starve for a day so I can wait for my delivery. Red flags to anyone's brains. I just need to know if I was the only one who was like, bitch, say what? Bitch, say what? Ma'am, you starved for a day because your HelloFresh was late? Anybody, how do we feel about this? KO Sandy says, I think going hungry seems far-fetched. So far, this feels like a fever dream. Like, I left the TV on, so I went to sleep. This Discord says, this fucking retard. Companies don't deliver their own packages on their own trucks. Jackson says, if you're complaining about something on TikTok, that's already a problem. Slushy says, I hate this kid. The drama. Man's is so stupid. What kind of fucking moron runs out of food on a day-to-day basis? Okay. Okay. Fuck. Okay, so Discord says, has this guy not heard of making rice with some cheap frozen veggies? Bros. Okay. I'm so excited to rant about this. Unless he has something that keeps him from going to the grocery store, this is really retarded. Lots of things to keep up with. Take care and keep up with. Gonna miss the TikTok, but I found a long-term part. Oh, I'm sorry. Violet, you're telling us about your life, and I thought you were talking about this guy. Discord says, how do you have money for a luxury service like HelloFresh, but not money for pantry staples? Okay, love this. Some people are bad at taking care of themselves. Pantry is bare. What? Oh, my God. I love your... Okay. Hangry and irrational. Let's go. Okay, ready? Let's press play and finish because, I'm going to rant.
My God. Wrong. I checked my tracking number today. Not once did it leave for delivery. As I get to the end of my day, I check it again. And now there's a second tracking number. And it says that my box has been split in two. So this, instant red flag, I call customer service. Customer service tells me... Oh, yeah, I see here on your account that there was a mistake with your box and they ended up having to repackage it. Okay, so now there's three excuses. Construction, weather, mistake with the box. I'm thoroughly confused at this point. So I ask her, is there any way you can help me? Because you understand that although you refunded me my money isn't going to be in my account for 5 to 10 business days because it's processing. She says, unfortunately, there's nothing I can do. I can't send you money, and I can't give you food today. I say, okay, obviously you can't help me with my problem, so I want to speak to your manager. And she says, okay, she transfers me to the manager. I explain the situation to the manager. She tells me, I'm sorry, there's nothing we can do except tell you where your box is. The manager tells me that my box isn't going to be delivered until Friday. I haven't eaten since Monday morning. So I'm going to go hungry until Friday because I spent the last of my money on this.
Tia says it's giving me care on. Stop.
Box. I don't have any more groceries in my house to eat. No groceries. Sorry, I'm running out of time. Part 2 is posted. Because of HelloFresh, I'm going hungry for the next.
Okay, let's go to part... Oh, hold on. It made me go to TikTok. Let's go to part 2. Here we go.
So like I was saying, I'm going to go hungry for the next 5 days because I spent the last of my money on this box that's not going to show up till Friday. I don't have any more groceries in my house to eat.
Habibi, 5 days.
And they say they can't do a single thing for me. They can't send any money to a Venmo, to my email. They can't do anything like that so I can actually eat.
Hi, Amazon. This vibrator bot doesn't work. Can I return it and you can Venmo me my money? Habibi. This is not how the adult world works.
Because again, my money's processing and I'm not going to get it for 5 days. So yeah, I had to get it.
Yeah, nothing happens for 3 to 5 days in the States. Like, I know other people in other countries think it's crazy, but in normal world, even Patreon doesn't get me my money for 3 to 5 days. Everyone doesn't get their money for 3 to 5 days.
I do, a little fast for 5 days. Thanks, HelloFresh. Shout out the boy. Yeah, that's all I got. That's my story.
Okay, so somewhere in this article, it reads, hold on. I just want to get the number correct. I think it's $180 he spent on his last, is this the same guy?
So my HelloFresh ice packs were melted. Yay, let's see what we got. Hey look, there's more condiments for everybody. Anyway.
Oh, you got food in your fridge, bitch.
Chicken cutlets in a bag.
Eat the very can cool. of mushrooms. That's food.
Those.
Sour cream.
Look kind of orange. I don't know if you can see how much liquid is in the bag on camera, but it's like...
This man is the most unhappy human I've ever seen in my life. This man is a cold person. You know how I say there's warm people and cold people? This man is not a warm person. Like, I would... This man.
Let's see. Yummy. Now, let's be fair. Chicken can look a little funny sometimes in its packaging. It can be a little watery. So that one we'll disregard. Pork tenderloin. Doesn't look bad. Feels a little warm. Not a good sign. So I didn't...
I swear, he's the kind of guy that if somebody gave him $1 million, he'd be like, oh, now I have to pay tax on this $1 million. Like, this guy will never be happy. Oops, I muted it.
I didn't get that on camera, but as soon as I picked up the shrimp, water or juice or something.
Oh my gosh. You mean condensation happened? This guy is, this is a comedy show. This is like a bubble, I forgot, funky smell.
It did as soon as I took it out of the fucking box.
Dead animal smelled? Holy fuck.
Like, look at that. It's literally fucking, like, shiny. Just for you guys.
Shiny. This is shiny. What's that song from Moana?
Because I'll give it a closer smell.
Smells like a girlfriend's pussy.
Yeah, you guys guessed it. That one's definitely rotten. So, all of my lettuce is, like, really wet. It looks pretty wilted. Grapes.
I love him.
Tons of moisture in the bag. I mean, honestly, moisture isn't an automatic turnoff, but the fact that there's moisture in everything kind of just tells me that it was thawed, which I know because those fucking ice bags were liquid. Nothing bad to report in the spaghetti box, but, you know, again, liquid in the fucking green container and they're soft.
Okay. Y'all ever get fresh washed spinach from the supermarket? It's wet inside, boo-boos. That's why you have to use your greens quickly and then, you know, be reasonable with your greens.
So when dill gets slimy and black like that...
I want to open up the package.
Like that.
I want to see you touch it.
Like that.
No offense, this man doesn't cook anyway, so he doesn't know what a good thing was or a bad thing was.
Brown all over my green beans. About half of them are brown. Nothing wrong to report with the vegetables or the condiments of the fajitas, but the shrimp, fuck.
Okay, so we see this man is just unhappy with existence, right? He just cannot exist. He doesn't understand how to be an adult. I love it for him. Okay, I just want to look up. There was a number price on this fucking story. Was it $50? Was it $180? I know he said it. I know. I remember because I discussed it with my sister. I think it was his last $180 or something like that he spent on HelloFresh. Did you guys hear him say a number? I swear. I swear there was... Am I missing it? There was... Okay, hold on. Seth addressed these comments in an additional video stating that while he did have some food in his house, like crackers, oatmeal, flour, spices, milk, bitch, you got a cake, you got pancakes, you got breakfast, you got everything you need to survive for 30 fucking days, and you go and buy HelloFresh, I'm gonna start ranting again. Fuck this. Okay, so this is what I forgot. So I sent this to my sister, I talked to my partners about it. Okay, and I was like, so let me get this straight, Bros. He has oatmeal in his cabinet, and he has flour. You good, bitch. You don't need nothing else, bitch. That's nothing else, bitch. And then, let me tell you. So I told my sister, I was like, this man is lying. He's scamming. He wants money from HelloFresh. And she goes, no, Brittany, I think some poor people are just uneducated. I was like, no, we grew up poor. And this is 1,000% not a poor person. Poor people know how to eat. And then she goes, some poor people don't know how to spend money. And I was like, I forgot that there are poor people who actually don't know how to buy food like poor people buy food. So this is what I mean by that, right? If I had, okay, so I think I remember the number being 180, but I could be wrong. I looked, so in order to prepare for the story, I went to HelloFresh and I tried to sign up for like an account to see how much it would cost me. Okay, so I went to HelloFresh and it was $50 a week for 6 meals. Okay, so for $50 a week for 6 meals for 2 people, so like that's 3 meals each. I'm thinking about this and I'm like, okay, for $50, bro, you could buy like 4 things of oatmeal, a bunch of eggs, a bunch of proteins, a ton of chicken. Chicken's like $1.99 to $6 a pound, depending on the chicken you're getting. And I'm sitting here like, no. Barley's, lentils. Like my mom growing up, because we had 10 kids, one income, and my dad made about 6 figures later in life. So when my mom and dad first had me, I was their third child. They didn't have money. And then I don't know when my dad started making 6 figures, actually. Hold up. I wonder when that started. He must have had like 6 kids before he made that much money. But my mom was the mom who would make us dinner and go, okay, kids, guess how much it cost me to feed all of you. And then we'd all do the math. And I do that now. I'm like, how much did I spend to feed this whole family? I've been doing this thing. Then I watched MasterChef and there was a girl named Lexi, love Lexi, feeds her family of four off $40 a week for groceries because they don't have enough money, right? And I'm like, I believe you. I think this is possible. Are you eating like again, a lot of oatmeals, a lot of stuff like that? Yes, you are. Cream of wheat. Yes, you're eating things that maybe you don't want. Maybe you want veal. Maybe you want lobster. Well, suck it up, bitch. You're poor. Like, okay, but just because you're poor doesn't mean you can't have things that taste delicious. Like rice dishes. So much of Assyrian food is poor. Actually, my partner was making me crack up. I made him hummus kabi and he goes, this feels like a poor person meal. And I was like, it is. You're right. I think he's correct. It is. My family was very poor in Iraq, especially my mom's family. My dad less so, but my mom's family was poor. And a lot of our meals are just tomato paste made into broth, rice, protein, and a vegetable. So if you're lucky, you have some beef, you take it and chop it up into small pieces, okay? Like a couple dollars worth of beef, maybe $5. Then you take some rice, big bag of rice, let's say it's $20. It can last you forever. And then you take some tomato paste. It's like, let's say a couple dollars for a big can, okay? That could feed you for literally a week. Like less than $10 could feed you for a week when you can buy in bulk and then use moving forward. But there's so much here. There's so much, but I forget. Okay, Discord says, hold on. Brittany, stop flaunting your poor privilege. You were lucky to be born poor and learn these things. Some people have to become poor by making bad decisions. Hilarious. But I actually was born in a poor, smart home, meaning that my parents, though immigrants and all the reasons to not be educated, knew enough about survival when it came to food. So it's kind of crazy to me that there are bubbles of people like this that pick a premium service, which is such a privileged fucking thing. I, right now, making $80,000 a year, refuse to do HelloFresh. It's so outside my budget. It's so outside my budget. I could never justify HelloFresh on an $80,000 salary if I want to have kids. Like, that's so irresponsible for your money. Like, it just makes no sense to me at all. Like, even my new diet with my lupus, I have to like drink like organic. It's costing me a shit ton of money, but I can justify it towards my health. But if everybody knows this, for me, everyone knows that the moment I run out of money, I just stop eating or I eat dirt poor food. So my partner and I were talking about our favorite poor people meals. One of my go-to staples was just white rice with some AO1 sauce. I ain't gonna pretend like I'm fancy. Like if your girl has to, I will just eat a bowl of white rice with A1 sauce, girl. I've been poor. I know what not having money, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get it. I didn't have money for so long. Or when I was in my 20s and I was going through my starving stage, I would just find pennies and nickels on the floor and then I'd go to work because I worked at Ralph's. It's a grocery store. And I would just buy $1.50 worth of a croissant and a chicken salad, and that would be my one meal a day. $1.50, and I was starving. Like, I was definitely not getting my calories. But your bitch will find pennies on the floor if I have to. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't understand the idea that he doesn't have enough. Like, can't you walk on a sidewalk, go find fucking four quarters and buy a dollar worth of oatmeal and not the prepackaged oatmeal? Guys, I have to tell you. Okay, so I'm just going to tell you this. Ready? Are you ready? Every time you buy something at the store, because maybe you don't know this, that is prepackaged and convenient for you, you are paying a premium price. The more convenient it is for you, it is premium price, right? If you make things from scratch, if you go and buy the bulk items you need, you can make 1,000 meals and compare to the one you can make by just getting the convenience. If you go to oatmeal and you get like a $7 box of oatmeal that's prepackaged and has all those sugars and apples and all those bullshit stuff in it, that's bad for you anyways. And you get that. Yeah, you're paying a premium price for oatmeal that's prepackaged. So if you just buy a container of oatmeal, and I understand, I have lupus, so I can't even eat my oatmeal anymore, or my cream of rice, or my rice. So I understand if you have an autoimmune disorder or something like that, you won't be able to buy the cheap items. So you have to switch to eggs, which is cheap. So today, my partner taught me how to make French scrambled eggs. So delish, so much butter, but it's so cheap. So I made like breakfast today. I took like eggs. And I never want to eat eggs the way that my nutritionist wants me to eat eggs. But this French style of scrambled eggs is officially my favorite. It's so good. It is so good. But just think about it. Every time you go to the store and you're like, this is very convenient for me, you are paying the premium price. I used to work at the produce section of Ralph's, and I would wake up at 3 a.m. and get to work at 4, and I would chop up all your fruit. So you guys know the section in the grocery stores that's for people who are working? And you show up and it's like prepackaged fruit, you're paying a premium fucking price. When somebody, like, you're paying a premium fucking price. So that's because I had to do it. The company had to pay me to come in at 4 a.m. and chop your fucking fruit for you, you lazy piece of shit, because you didn't want to do it, which is fine. Because you're lazy, you pay a premium price. I make a salary, right? I was paid to cut your fruit for you. If you want to do it yourself, you save dollars. Worth it if you're poor. So for this guy to get on TikTok and to scream about like, oh, I'm going to starve for 5 days. Bitch, how are you going to starve for 5 days if you got oatmeal in your cabinet? And then somebody in the comment section here said literally what I was thinking. This is just you getting weeded out. The natural selection, baby. Natural selection, baby. If you cannot survive in a first world country with a fucking premium service, you can afford HelloFresh, which is a premium. That is for rich people. You know which one of my friends uses HelloFresh? Everyone who's in tech, who makes $150K a year. This is a premium price. This is expensive. Okay? Expensive. So again, for me to see this man ranting and being like, I'm gonna starve, doesn't it feel like a scam? So I will allow leeway for it either being a scam, which I don't care about, or there are bubbles of poor people who actually don't know how to survive poor. So I'm just going to tell you this right now, BBs. Okay? I'm going to tell you it again. If you are convenient, like if you were given convenience at the store, you are paying a premium price. Work a little bit harder. Dedicate one more extra time of your day. I know it sucks because some of you are working 3 jobs. But it is worth it. Buying rice, you can fucking pop into the oven, not the oven, onto the stove or in the microwave with some protein on the side. Or if you're vegan, you can go the vegan route. But either way, like, y'all cannot be paying these premium prices and then saying things like, I'm starving. Bitch, how don't you like have, where are your ethics, bro? Where are your ethics? Like, have you had a conversation with yourself about your values? Because basically you're stealing from yourself. This man is Amazoning himself. This man is like bad capitalism himself. He took advantage of himself. And then he blamed HelloFresh when HelloFresh did not force you to sign up for their premium service, my friend. And if he was a parent, he would be a neglectful parent that honestly should probably have his kids taken away. Think about it that way. Think about if this man had children and he let them starve even though they had oatmeal in the cabinet because HelloFresh didn't get delivered. How could this man treat himself so poorly? How could this man look himself in the mirror and say, even though I could eat a perfectly decent meal, and be more than content, I'm just gonna starve. Because I was so fucking stupid. This is a beautiful story. Okay, let me read your comments. Because they were hilarious. Someone said, is this a one? It makes you wonder. How introspective do you think this man is? How much, like, do you think this man spends any time being introspective about his choices? This man, is he useless to both his community and himself? He's obviously useless to himself. The man doesn't know how to feed himself, which is something a baby doesn't know how to do. And yet, my 2-year-old niece 100% will find food. My nieces and nephews one time, oh my gosh, there's something in my eye. One time there was just like hours and hours went by and we were all hanging out and we were all kind of like loosely snacking. But one time the baby, he was like 3 or something, he went onto the counter, which is safe for him. It's like baby height. He went onto this little counter and grabbed some food. And we caught him like a few minutes later and I was like, what are you doing? He's like, I was hungry. And I was like, oh, okay, the kid's hungry. And look at him figuring out how to find food. So basically this man is dumber than my 3-year-old nephew who did the math. I'm hungry. What should I do? Eat. So my 3-year-old nephew was able to say, I should just eat food that's available to me. And this grown-ass man could not figure out how to put food in his mouth. But he figured out how to go into HelloFresh and sign up for a premium service. What is that? Like, what kind of a human is that? What am I dealing with here? How compassionate should I feel? How much should I suffer with him? How sorry can I feel about this man and his decisions? And then how does that make you feel as a person? Are we bad people because we don't feel bad for him? Or should we feel bad for him because he was once a baby who was so stupid he grew into an adult that could not manage to feed himself? Unless it's just a scam. And in that case, it's a bad scam. Because honestly, if you're going to scam HelloFresh, you could have done it so many other ways. I'm actually disabled and I can't walk and I can't leave my house because I have an autoimmune disorder and I can't get COVID. And now I have to starve and there's no food in my pantries. And then he should have showed his empty pantries. He should have made up a whole story about, like, if you're going to scam, you've got to go 110%, boo-boo. You got to scam all the way. My mom is dead. I have no dog. I have no future. I have no legs. Like, you got to really hone in on the victim card if you're really going to play that game. Because otherwise, you're just uneducated, and I'm not sure how to feel about this, right? Because I am much more lenient on people that are uneducated, but because he went so hard, because he was like, the packaging is shiny. I can't help but feel like this is scammy. What do you guys think, though?